Hello, sweet friends. Welcome back to another weekly vlog.
It's Monday today, and we actually had a really exciting delivery. It's taking up half of my living room right now, but we received our dining table, which is so exciting.
It's from Temple & Webster. It arrived while I was at work today, and Liam texted me saying we can put it together after dinner tonight, which I'm so excited to finally have
a dining table. We've actually just been eating outside on our balcony with this little outdoor dining set that we've had. Like, I have actually had it since I moved out of home, and it's been really nice to sit outside because of the warmer evenings, but I also really enjoy having a dining table, having a dining room, also working from the dining table, like editing and stuff will be really nice. Also, yesterday I ended up ordering some dining chairs. How many times can I say dining in like 2 minutes? But yeah, we ordered some chairs, which I'm really excited about. They're actually just from Kmart, but I've been eyeing them off for a while and they just came in stock. So I ordered those yesterday, but right now I'm making dinner. I'm making like a teriyaki chicken bowl tonight. So we have some rice in the rice cooker. I was watching Kenzie Elizabeth's video. I'm steaming up some vegetables. I need to add the carrot in there in a second. And I've already been marinating the chicken for a while. So that should be really good. This is a super easy meal and also a really great way to incorporate a lot of veggies. So I'm gonna keep cooking and I'll talk to you guys. I don't know. Maybe I'll show you the final product. It's now Tuesday. I forgot to film the teriyaki bowls, but there's worse news to come. Obviously, I was really excited about our dining table. There it is. Half of it. They only sent us half the package. So this specific table comes in two boxes, and they only sent us one box, so we're missing the legs of the table. So I've emailed them and I'm dealing with all of that, whatever, but it is just kind of frustrating. We ordered it from Temple & Webster. We also ordered Liam's desk from Temple & Webster, and we've had issues with both of the things that we've ordered so far, which is so frustrating because we heard amazing things from them, and that's why we chose to go with Temple & Webster, because we had such great reviews from our friends and family, but I don't know how I feel. The product itself, incredible quality. It's just the delivery company that seems to be the issue, and I'm pretty sure that's like external to Temple & Webster anyway, but we can stop chatting about it. I wanted to sit down and chat. I thought it'd be fun to film in my office. Give me 2 seconds while I set up this tripod. How cute does that look? Are you joking? I'm really loving this office transformation. It's coming together so cute. So how was my Tuesday, you may ask? Honestly, I'm exhausted and I'm not really sure why. I think it's about 4:30. Maybe it's closer to 5. Oh, it really is like 5 p.m. And at 4 p.m. I just hit a major slump. I don't know what's going on. I should have had a coffee when I got home from work and I didn't. And then I hit the afternoon slump and I just haven't been able to do anything. I posted an Instagram photo. I scrolled through Pinterest, which honestly is something that I do like to do every day because it does keep me super inspired with my content, but I probably just could have done more with my afternoon, you know? In saying that, I got ready for work super quick this morning. I don't really know why I was able to get ready so quickly. I usually try and get ready for work by 7 a.m., which means that I have from 7 till 8 to do YouTube stuff, so emails, editing, filming, whatever I might need to do. This morning, I got ready at 6:30, and I was able to spend an hour and a half doing YouTube work, and I honestly got almost all my work done that I was supposed to do this whole day done this morning, which was chef's kiss. I did also edit for a long time yesterday, so I'm kind of just happy with the progress I made today. However, this afternoon, the motivation was really just lacking, so I'm glad I got that afternoon stuff done. Moving on. I got a package I wanted to open with you. Nothing major, but still pretty exciting. Like I mentioned, I've been on Pinterest pretty much every day recently, and I have been loving it. It has just been so fun to look through everything. I've got a lot of inspo for my office here, a lot of outfits that I want to try and recreate, or even just get inspo from a lot of like styling things, Instagram, photo inspo. I've just been really enjoying it. And I saw a hair clip on there, and I was like, my friend Gabby sells those. So I ordered from her small business. Wait, what? There are two things in here. I only ordered one thing. I'm gonna leave her business link down below because it has some really cute stuff. Hi Rachel, thank you for your order. We hope you love your new Gabsy's hair claw. Have popped in an extra little something for you too. Thank you, Gabby. Oh, that's so sweet. I went to high school with Gabby. We played on the same touch football team and she's just a lovely gal. And I just really wanna make an effort to support more small businesses. Like I said, I saw a hair clip on Pinterest. I knew she sold one like the exact same. And I was like, I need it. Also, packaging is so cute. So this is the hair clip. How stinking cute is that? I'm actually wearing a claw clip right now. I don't know if you can see it. This one's just from Kmart, but this one looks super, super cool. And I think this will make a really cool Instagram photo. And of course, just keep my hair out of my face while I'm working and stuff. Let's be practical, but make it trendy. Oh, that's nice. Like, that really just holds the hair really well. We love to see it. I mean, I can't see it, but hopefully it looks good. And then she sent something extra, which is very nice of her. Oh, cute. That is such a beautiful color. I've been loving greens lately, like sage, olive, any sort of muted shade of green is so up my alley at the moment, and that is gorgeous. I also think some of the kids think I'm really cool when I wear a scrunchie to work, so 10 points for Miss Rachel. Anyway, that's all I have to show you guys. I am gonna probably just chill for a while. I will start making dinner soon though. And then Liam will be home later and we have a bit of a date night tonight. I don't know what we're gonna do. I'm so exhausted, maybe just watch a movie or something.
Good morning, friends. Happy Wednesday, halfway through the week. Last night I fell asleep at 8 p.m. I was just so exhausted, honestly. I don't know why. I really don't have a reason. I was just tired, needed some sleep, and I slept for a solid 9 hours straight. So good. I just got to work. I got here a bit early, which is like kind of annoying because I'm like, what am I supposed to do, you know? But this afternoon after I finish work, I'm going to head to my parents' house and visit them. My mom finishes work early today. So I'm gonna meet her there. I have like good news and bad news. Lighting is shocking, I apologize. I haven't talked about it because it's just like upsetting to me and I'm very bad at talking about things that like significantly upset me. That's just how I've always been. But Milo passed away while I was on my honeymoon, so a few weeks ago, and I did cry for a long time. But in saying that, I definitely knew it was coming. He was really old. He had so many health problems. He had so many vet appointments. They were keeping constant track of him. He was on medication. It was just like a lot. And by the time that he passed away, it was definitely his time. Milo has been in my life for over a decade, which is like half my life. Since I was 10 years old, Milo has been in our family. And the first time I went to my parents' house after him passing, it just felt wrong. Like, it genuinely felt wrong. Like, it felt like something was missing. I just wanted to let you guys know because obviously you've heard so many updates about him and his health journey over the past like year or so. And I just wanted to keep you in the loop. But in saying that, Bailey, our other family dog, has always grown up with Milo. So for Bailey's whole life, he has always been constantly with Milo. And my parents were worried that after Milo passed, that he would get really sad and really lonely because he's not used to being by himself. So they actually decided, which I was really surprised about, to be completely honest, they decided to adopt another little dog. They rescued a little lab cross retriever called Tilly. She's 6 months old and I think they only picked her up yesterday. So she's not like a puppy, but she is definitely a younger dog. And it's very bittersweet because I am really sad that Milo is gone, but I do think Bailey really needs a companion. And I think my parents really enjoy having two dogs as well. And I am really excited to see what Tilly is like and get to meet her and spend time with her. A golden retriever is my dream dog, so I'm excited to see that part of her personality. We have always only really had Marimers cross something. Milo was a Marimer cross border collie, and Bailey is a Marimer cross Labrador, and Tilly is a lab cross retriever. So like, her face looks very similar to Bailey's, but she's a lot smaller. In saying that, Bailey is literally a huge dog. Milo was a huge dog, so she is still a big dog, but she's just a lot smaller in comparison to those big boys. But yeah, I'm really, really, really excited to meet her and see what she's like. But I'm gonna go to work and I will see you guys later this afternoon and we can go meet Tilly.
Hello. Tilly! Tilly! Hello! Hello! Oh, what a pretty girl!
Good morning, guys. Happy Thursday. We are so close to the weekend and I'm so excited. I feel like I say that in every work week in my life. I apologize, but we have some good news.
Yesterday, this package miraculously arrived outside our door. It's a bit odd, bit sketch. I did make a complaint and it did just happen to magically appear after that complaint was made. I mean, it was a nice complaint, but you know what I mean. And also when the tabletop arrived, it like sent me a text and it was like telling me about the tracking and like all of this stuff. And this one just appeared, no text, no explanation, but I'm glad it's here. So I think Liam is actually going to put this together while I'm at work today, which is extremely exciting because I don't have to build it.
He has the morning off and he's actually going to pick up a drill from his parents' house so that he can build it because it's a bit more heavy duty than some of the IKEA flat packs that we've put together. But it looks like a beautiful piece of furniture and I'm very excited to have a dining room table. And I actually just got a text yesterday saying that our dining chairs are on their way, so they'll probably be here in a couple of days, which is, again, very exciting. And I think Liam's desk may arrive today, which, again, very exciting, because right now we just have a corner full of desk things for him. But yeah, I'm about to head off to work, so I'll talk to you guys later today.
Good afternoon, guys. It's finally Friday afternoon. It's the weekend and I'm so happy. This week was just a long one. I don't really know why. Today on my way home, I went to grab some groceries and I went to my PO box, so I have some packages to open with you guys. And obviously came home. It was one of those days where I just wanted to get out of my clothes, out of my makeup, so I washed my face. So now I'm all barefaced and in a comfy little matching set from Princess Polly that I've had for ages. But I have some exciting news for you guys, so I wanted to share it with you. I mean, it's not that crazy, but I think it's exciting.
We officially have our dining table set up. Liam built this the other day while I was at work and it looks incredible. I'm obsessed with it. I love it. It matches our bookcases like perfect. And even more exciting, today we received our dining chairs. These are actually from Kmart. This is what they look like and I think they're gonna look so good. They're a very similar color to our couch actually, but they're not the exact color that we wanted on the bottom, which we knew when we ordered them that they would be like this. Also, I think these are an online exclusive if you're wondering.
But because they're not the exact color that we wanted, I actually decided to order some this is a bit of an experiment. I don't really know if it's gonna work, but we're gonna try it out. I ordered some contact paper that looks like wood and it's a darker shade of wood, and we're thinking we might be able to wrap the legs in this in this contact paper so that they will match the rest of the wood that we have. This looks pretty good actually. Oh wow, there's so much of it. That's amazing. It is almost a little bit too dark, but I think it'll match pretty well. I only ordered one roll of this in case it wasn't the right color, but this cost me like 10 bucks on Amazon. And look at that. That looks actually really good. So it's just contact paper in this dark like walnut kind of color. And I'm gonna try wrapping the legs of the chairs in this color so that they match our apartment. So those are the packages from today. I'm gonna try and see if I can get these. Actually, no, I do need to do some YouTube work before I get this leg stuff sorted, but hopefully it works out really well. I'll give you guys updates. Good morning guys, it is now Sunday, which means it's Valentine's Day. Liam and I never do anything crazy for Valentine's Day. We usually just do something small, like a picnic or something. And this year when we were discussing what we should do, we were like, honestly, if we go anywhere, it's gonna be so crazy busy, so let's just have a really nice big breakfast at home. So that's what we're doing today. We're just making like our favorite breakfast. So Liam's having bacon and eggs and toast and stuff. And I'm having avocado on toast with feta. Like we're just kind of doing it a bit nicer. I also put a fruit platter out. I don't know, just a bit of a nicer breakfast. Happy Valentine's Day, puppy.
Liam's cooking up some bacon here. We have some toast over there. And then we just have some juice and some fruit. So nothing too crazy, but just some good quality beefest.
Hey guys, so this vlog was just a mess. It was honestly just a mess. But I wanted to sit down and give you guys a bit more of a proper house update. Because I told you we got a new dining table, didn't end up showing you. Told you we were getting Liam's desk, didn't end up showing you. So I wanted to show you those things. Obviously we haven't finished decorating anything yet, but we have got a few more pieces and I wanted to actually show you instead of just talking about them. So it's actually a couple weeks later after filming those clips, but this will be the last vlog before everything's up to date again. My next vlog will be like in real time, which will be nice. But let me show you guys all of those updates.
Here is the dining table all complete. I think it is such a beautiful color. And here are our chairs. So they are from Kmart like I showed you guys, but I did wrap the bottom of the legs in the contact paper. It is a little bit darker than the legs of the chair, but I feel like it's all right. If I do end up finding better contact paper, I might redo it, but I think it's fine for now. But I do definitely want to get a white rug to go underneath here because it is definitely a bit dark in this kind of area of the house. But it is so nice to have the dining room come together. And we can fit both chairs around that side, so I have two and two. But this way is just more practical when it's just Liam and I, because we do have more room, but we can always move it. We also got our coffee table, which I love. I think it is so cool. I'll include a little clip of me building it. I think all the furniture I'm showing you is from Temple and Webster. We just ordered heaps, and I will say it's kind of hit and miss. Some pieces are definitely better quality than others, but I really like how this looks. Definitely needs some decor. I think a little like white tray with a candle or something on top would look really nice, and some coffee table books or photo albums in this little area would look nice as well. And then we also got this little side table, which is such a nice little addition. We don't really have anything in there yet. It's more for aesthetics. It is a bit smaller than I thought, but I think it still does fit the space really nicely and look really good. We also got Liam's desk. This is just a white corner desk, again from Temple and Webster. Super simple, and I think it looks nice in the corner, and I'm glad he has a study area finally. This is my old Alex 5 drawers from IKEA, but we moved them out here because it kind of just fits this space better, and Liam can use this for storage. I wasn't even using it.
And then I think the last little furniture update we have is this little side table for next to our bed.
Again from Temple and Webster. I really, really love how this looks. And I've just popped a little lamp, and then this little thrifted vase, and the eucalyptus leaves that Liam gave me when we got engaged. I just dried them out, and I really like how it looks. It's so nice to have a bedside table now, so I'm glad we have that sorted as well.
I feel like the apartment is slowly coming together. Like I mentioned, I still want to get another rug for the dining room. I want to get some decor pieces for the coffee table, stuff like that, but I feel like most of the main things are done. And in the next vlog that you'll see, I did a bunch of stuff to my office, which you can kind of see a little sneak peek of in the background, but I've been really enjoying kind of sharing the little process of us decorating and filling in our apartment. It is definitely feeling like a home. I think we've been here for about, well, I mean, since we like got married, it's only been just over a month, like a month and a half. And I don't know if I'll do an apartment tour eventually. Maybe when it's like completely decorated. We still, again, have so much to do. I would love to get some canvases and things on the walls, some art and stuff, but we will see. The other thing I wanted to talk about in this vlog is just kind of a little bit of a chat, and maybe you don't want to hear it and that's fine, but I'm just going to talk to those of you who might actually listen. Like I said earlier, this vlog was filmed like almost a month ago. It was filmed the week of Valentine's Day, which was like halfway through February, and now we're like a week into March. And I did take like 2 weeks, two-ish, 2.5 weeks off vlogging just because I needed it. I was getting to a point where not necessarily the filming was stressing me out, but just like the amount of work I had to do. So filming, editing, emails, all of it. It was just becoming a bit much, especially because I had so much content from the wedding and stuff still to be uploaded. Like there was just so much swarming around my head, and I was already working like 10 to 12 hour days because I would go to work for most of the day and then come home and do like 3 to 5 hours at home of just YouTube stuff. And I don't want to say I burnt out, but I definitely was getting to a point where I felt like that could have been a possibility. I felt like I was watching myself fall into that hole, and I just needed to get out of it. So I decided to just take a couple weeks off, which is what I did, obviously, and I am feeling so much better now. It's weird because I was genuinely feeling so happy and so like in love with my life. I was so happy with just how good life was, but just the work side of everything was getting a bit overwhelming. So I just needed to take a step back. And my advice for you is that if you can like feel yourself getting to a point where you can see burnout or exhaustion just kind of creeping up on you, then you definitely need to take some sort of preventative measure, like taking a week off, like coming home and having a bath instead of actually doing 3 hours of emails. Whatever it may be for you, take those preventative steps to stop yourself from getting to that point, because it is so harmful to yourself. And I know that I personally don't want to get to that point. I never want to hate doing this. Like, I love YouTube. It's my passion and it brings me so much joy. So I never want to get to a point where I'm like, oh my gosh, I have to go home and do YouTube work. Like, I don't want to be like that. So if you're in that point, whether it's a side hustle, whether it's going to work, whether it's whatever it may be, if you can just take a step back, chill out a little bit. And I was so excited to come back. I was so excited to start vlogging again. And like I mentioned, I do have way more vlogs coming in the future, of course. But yeah, there's my little update for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed this vlog, even though it was such a mess. And I can't wait to get back into these weekly vlogs consistently and to continue to just share my life with you guys. But I love you, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.